And welcome to Utawarerumono, Mask of Deception, episode 49. Yep, soon close to 50 episodes of this, and damn. But anyway, let's continue. This is... She quickly begins pushing more into her mouth, eagerly. Okay. The mountain of sweets prepared for Anju begins to grow smaller by Munechika's hand.
Yeah.
Are those meant for you, really? Really? The princess releases Kuan's cheek to rush over to Munechika. The rest of the room stands dumbstruck, watching at the phrase, continues to play out. Tap, tap. Okay, but what, yeah. Okay. Yeah, seemed pretty worked up. Yeah, he's below generals, that's what I thought. Guarding himself. Yeah, well, it's Saku we're talking about. Okay, well. Let us return. never ever. Okay. By
four.
Okay.
Huh.
Oh, yeah. That one too. Munechika takes a book Anju is preferring to her. She opens it and begins to skim its contents. And as she returns the pages, she stares deeper and deeper into them, totally absorbed. Friendship, yeah, between two men, not arresting, yeah. So you can kind of understand right now. I think I don't know if I said it, but you can kind of understand right now what kind of book it actually is.
むしろ学ぶためにこそ宮廷の中では決して学べぬことが。いや、オッケー。さっきと言ってること。何事からも学ばんとする。オッケー。いや、わかったのなら、こちらは小生が預からせていただきます。おお、わお。
He quickly pockets the offhanding books, secreting it away? Okay. Okay. Wow. That book is actually, yeah. She coolly turns away from Anju to sample another one of Rute's sweets. Actually, it's my stomach. Poor Kimiru has been doubled over this entire time. Rute looks to be at a loss, tears in her eyes. Kuan glances towards me with a look that says do something, and Ekina rapidly nods her agreement.
この状況をどうしろと。
As he joins Minichika, continuing to eat without a care in the world. Good at him, wobbles in place, looking a little fearful as if he might be eaten just as easily. What are we gonna do about all this? Well, it's your job to figure that out. Oh, that was actually it. Alright. So, what the fuck? Question marks? No, that has to be... Oh shit, I actually wonder if we do take this one and not that one, will this one disappear? Because it feels like... What can that be? There's question marks there. You know what? I think we will, because we should be able to see all of them. So let's take the question marks and see what that is. Okay. Oh, hello. One afternoon, Minishika suddenly came by our headquarters. Pleasure to meet you. Yeah? Pleasant surprise spread across Minichika's face upon hearing the name. Okay. None of that, please. Okay. So she's not the most dangerous one, I guess. Why did this one have question? Well, I guess it kind of didn't really know what to call it, maybe. Minichika glances at the ceiling for a moment. So she's gonna. Okay, well. She is gonna go here and get more books. Is that what it's gonna be? Alright, here we are. Trailing behind Kyo, and Minichika pauses as she catches sight of something. Her eyes falls on the plate Atui is holding. Oh, so much about, yeah. Yay! Yeah, well, it's our own recipe. Oh. Atui holds a piece of rulu on a toothpick for Minichika, who hesitates slightly. Then, with Atui smiling innocently at her, she nods and takes a bite. I actually wonder how she will be in the third game if she will know the thing that you will see in the end. I never actually thought about that when I watched the anime. If she will actually notice that that happens in the end. But it, we'll see about that. We'll see about that. I have the third game and I'm gonna play it, so you will see. I'm just more curious right now.
Yeah.
In a matter of seconds or two, his entire plate disappeared. Decent indeed, yeah. Mirzika clapped her hand together as a sign of thanks. Lute appears in the doorway. Not
exactly.
Lute offers a different blade to the dejected Atui. On it sits a batch of confection crepes, golden and round. We are gonna check out those looks soon. Okay, let's go check that right now and just check. So it's gonna be, should be lifestyle, really. Or not? Is it misc? No. Can't be creatures. No, not locations. Oh, culture. Sorry, but no, it can't be culture. Don't they have what they? Let's see here. Let's go on all until we find something new. If there is something new. There is a lot of shit. There is none. What is... So they don't have... They don't have that. They... Wow. Alright. Well, never mind. I guess we have to go by the descriptions of them. Or it... No, it can't be that they already... exist, right? Like... Puffs. Let's see here. Oh, they have to go in letter... No, it doesn't seem to... Oh, well. Well. To taste test, huh? Absolutely. So I can kind of understand why there were question marks, because I wouldn't really know what to call it either, but because I assume they have like standard like guard post in bedroom, you know, kind of like that. So I can understand why that would be question marks, as if you wouldn't really know what to call it, but... Each of us grabs a puff from the platter. In unison, we each take an experimental bite. Okay. Yay! But how, yeah. Indeed. Rute looks over to me, a little confused on how to answer the question. Yeah, it was us. Okay.
実際いろいろやった結果なんだが、要するに
into a... As I begin to explain, I realize I have an opportunity to have a little fun. Wow.
Oh.
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 Okay. She pops a puff into her mouth as she makes this proclamation, focusing intentionally. She seems to be too distracted by the taste to analyze it properly. It would be a waste, huh? Yeah.
It.
So we're getting more friendly with her too. I guess that's good. Minutsuka continues to eat one puff after another, showing no sign of stopping anytime soon.
Mm-hmm.
Yay. I made plenty.
Yay.
Wow. Yeah, marry you, alright?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's not like that, I was about to say. Uh-huh, okay. Took you by surprise. Mm-hmm. Okay. Yes. Yes, man. Atoy reaches for the plate. Only to find that the mountain of sweets has been reduced to a single lonesome puff. In that moment, another hand snaps out like a coiled snake and snatches the final puff up. Oh. Mmm. Sugary bliss, okay. Okay. With that, Minutsuka finds a couch to sink into, visibly relaxed. Atoy continues staring absentmindedly at the empty plate. Kuban holds about 6 or 7 puffs in her hand as she says this. Oh, now he's gonna get a glare. Okay. I'm sorry.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
You
should bake them yourself, sell them in your own stand, and just like, yeah. Maybe like, yeah, I don't, you could make so much money.
Yeah.
Okay, why are they? As Minutsuka listens to Negana's musings from the couch, she noticed something across the room. A book! To see the volume wedged between the shelves from across the room, she sure has a monofuse eyes. I thought, Yeah, Minutsuka flips through the book, pausing on a particular page, she flips it around and displays it. okay. I can see Ute's entire body twitch at the sight of the large illustration in front of us. Splayed across both pages, two young men stare into each other's eyes, petals falling around them. Yep. Is it me, or are they just a little too close for comfort? Oh. Well, Rurutia stutters, going rigid as the whole room turns to her. The room fills with defaming silence. Yeah, like Haku knows, yeah. Rurutia seems to realize the full implication of what she just said. Curling up and cradling her head.
Mm-hmm.
With that, she turns and begins to pull book after book from the shelf.
Okay.
Yeah. She quickly tucks a whole lot away, leaving a barren shelf behind. Nonchalantly, she selects the books on the top of the stack and begins to read. The limited edition, yeah. Rurutia collapses to the ground again, muttering distantly. Sunetsuki, however, is far too engrossed in her reading to notice the odd behavior. None of us can muster the courage to say anything as she reads in intense silence. Nekone sounds impressed, but it's all I can do to just shake my head. Or all I can do is just... Yeah, okay, well... Okay, so actually a pretty good time, I think, yeah? Yeah, pretty good time. So now we have Back Alley Store, which is... It looks like the bookstore. And now you can... Like, I don't really know what it's called. Because I don't watch it, but it's what is it called? It's between two men, let's say it like that, you know, not as friends, but more the romantic parts. I don't know what that kind of manga or novels are called. Well, I've heard it, but I can't get it in my head. And one of the reasons is because I don't read them or research about them. So yeah, but. I think we'll take Guard Post for the next episode, and then we will take Back Alley Store, and then we'll see what happens after that. But I hope you enjoyed this video, and until next time, be cool.